lab focuses on dynamic micro and nano structures. And so I think these days I oftentimes tell people that I'm making very, very tiny medical devices. When we work at the micro scale, we're working on the sorts of sensors and actuators that change shape or self-assemble, literally build themselves when we stretch them. And in that sense, they can be a sensor or an actuator. At the nanoscale, so we also build using a scaffolding that's a lot like hard plastic. And we will build nanostructures that we're trying to dynamically change. And so the interesting thing with that work is the material is actually DNA. We're working on nanosensors that could report back to us what the biomechanical conditions are. So one example system is this little spring. So it's a lot like this spring, right? And we form it like a straight tube, and we can actually make certain segments too short so that there's pre-stress induced and it'll actually take a helical configuration. And so this is actually by itself kind of cool, because if you embed this in a soft material or stick it to the surface, when that material gets stretched, you can actually get your structure to stretch. And so then it kind of works like a nanoscale strain gauge, right? But the really fun thing with this project is, on demand, we can uncoil it and then recoil it. So you could imagine it stretching and then relaxing. And when you put it inside a biological environment, one goal for this project would be to say, can we use this as a stiffness sensor? So if we know how much it would change shape, either like overcoiling or undercoiling, when we told it to actuate, then when we put it inside of a gel, for example, when we tell it to coil, it won't coil as much if it's being pulled on by something else. And so we can actually get it to report how much shape change it experienced. And using that information, we could actually learn a little bit about what's pulling on it, what's holding it in place. So we're trying to use little helices as both strain and stiffness sensors. And then the third part of what we do really spans the two scales, so the micro and the nano scale. And so we're really interested in asking this question, if we can organize DNA to make nanostructures, and we can decorate them any way we want, so we can put proteins or molecules that fluoresce or metal ions, what if we use this sort of structure as an adapter to help us build bigger things? And so one system that we have is trying to link multiple magnetic microbeads so we can make a chain of pearls, and they're connected end to end. So this is a project where we're trying to make the smallest magnetically actuated microswimmer that could actually swim through your capillaries. And so if you think like a human capillary is 6 to 8 microns in diameter, that's about a tenth of the width of a human hair. And we're trying to make a robot that could swim through that. An interesting avenue for using micro robots would be for delivery of cargo, like delivery of a drug. So are you delivering heparin to break up a clot? Are you doing something even stranger? So like we would imagine these swimmers are actually held together by DNA origami. So it's like a bead and then a biosensor and then a bead and then a biosensor. And so what if our biosensors could actually react to make the swimmers clump together on demand? So we could actually theoretically create an artificial clot, or if we wanted to reduce blood flow in a certain area, maybe have this swarm of robots actually mesh together to create a gel, and then on demand break apart again. So a major takeaway from this work is that biology exists under load, under tension, right? So enzymes don't exist at equilibrium. Things are pulling on them. And I think that there is a fundamental place for mechanics and mechanical engineers in biology and biomedical research. And so I think that's just really exciting for mechanical engineers. So I'm in a mechanical engineering department fundamentally because these are the students that have the preparation that I'm looking for. And what that is physics, CAD, a willingness to get their hands dirty and to build things, even if for us, it oftentimes means a model. And what they're really building is so small that they can't see it. It's really exciting, but these biomachines, like the contractile machinery inside your skeletal muscle and inside your heart, these are really machines. They're coordinated, they're regulated, and they can be described using mechanical principles.